We are on the location and right there, that's the jungle. You can see all the cliffs up there. There are very steep cliffs. I don't know if you can really get up there.
And neither we wanna get up there, at least for today, and hope the bear doesn't come down to help us with our hunt. Today we are on a small expedition only on the lower part of the jungle till we find our color changing laser. These caves connects the other side of the jungle where our bear friend might be. Not waiting for our friend, we started our search. But these woods were too stubborn to give us what we want. These mosquitoes didn't even leave a single chance to increase our effort. Not realizing the chameleon wouldn't live under the rock. We searched underneath every rocks. Didn't miss a single guess up in the trees. Nor we left a single bow unbroken on our way. There was no single branch that did not raise our heartbeat with the hope of finding it. But we had found nothing. Every small plants and the vines were to tell us how beautiful this woods can be, and a wrong placing of hand might give us painful reddened bites. The moment when all our hopes were to be lost, every single branch seemed to be empty, all our excitement were to be converted into disappointment. I spotted something crawling slowly its way up to the tree.
Come here. We finally got one. Can you see that? Give me the camera. I'm gonna try to catch that one and get it up close for the camera, but it's really getting high and I don't want to disturb it, because once it gets disturbed, it's angry, it might bite you. Its bite is not that toxic, but it's painful. It was really hard to get this. It was really quick, you know. I thought it might be much slower, but it wasn't. It is so angry right now. I don't want to disturb it right now. I want to hold it, but the thing is, I can't. I have to wait for something. Look at this color. It is so beautiful. I'm really, really happy I could get hold on to this.
It can change its color according to the environment by spacing the guanine pigments underneath its skin. It is fascinating how they adopt the same color as its surrounding. These two pairs of eyes give them total 360 degree view. With the help of these qualities, it blends into the environment and is always hard to spot a chameleon in the wild. It can process two images at a time in its mind. And this is why I cannot tap him without being noticed. We have disturbed him enough to bite me. Not planning on taking a bite, I should release him on his comfort zone.
So I think that is enough. We gonna leave him where he was. Okay, fine. There we go. This was the hunt for chameleon and we succeeded it. We'll see you in the next adventure. Let's see what we can find.
If you guys want to see more hunts like this, then please subscribe and let us know on the comment section below. This is Rajesh Mandal and you are watching Trip the Wild. Come along and leave the wild with us.